filming the performance test. All throttle. See how it performs with the second battery. We're driving to the eye doctor today. Ethan's got to get some glasses. So we're going to take it a little slow right here. But once we get up on the main highway, we'll see what this thing can do for a little longer period of time. So far I put 56 miles on this bike. I definitely want to put more on it, but I have a lot of things to review. I'll kick on my blinker. If I was by myself, I'd probably hammer this thing everywhere. But I don't want to leave Ethan in the dust, because that's what would happen. So this is my first long distance ride with the dual battery setup. At least the first one that I'm recording. I have done a bunch of tests to make sure it's going to survive out here. And so far, it's working flawlessly. If you guys haven't seen the install video of my dual battery setup on the Ariel Rider Kepler, I'll leave a card up here, and then it'll be the last video that you'll see at the end on the ending credits. Last time I went down this road, I rode down the actual road itself and not the sidewalk. I don't think I'd do it right now, because it's, I literally just got off work, so everybody else is too. So it's a little too busy for that. Close to the highway. Thank you. We use 2% battery, if that, driving 4.3 miles. I'd say that's pretty good. Well, looks like we're crossing. Hello? What are you doing? No blinker, I guess. Take a stroll to Walmart, but we're gonna go the back way. Easier on myself. Go the back way. blinker. That nobody in front of me is gonna see. We've gone 15 miles so far. It shows 85% of battery left, but it's probably higher than that. Take the road all the way there. Normally I would take the park and cut across, but I don't need to. Definitely gonna have to change my battery here soon. I'll probably pull over up here to do it. Go after the spin. Oh god. trail, maybe? Not really sure. There's where the farmer's market is. Today, so we're not stopping anywhere here. I'm just driving by. I used to work at this building back when it was Circuit City. Used to hang out back here in the bay where they did car audio installs. That was pretty fun. Electric. Really? Can I take a picture right here? Dude, That's sweet. Go back the way we came. See how easy it is to return home. We're at 20.26 miles. Battery says 71%. However, I need to let it set so I can really tell how much battery we have left. Unfortunately, all you people behind me gotta go around in the middle lane because there is no shoulder here. Unlike the other side, there is a shoulder. This side doesn't have one. To be doing pretty good. Almost 22 miles. Of power, but nothing major. says 61%. Looks like we're at 58%. We've gone almost 25 miles. Miles so far. 40. Yeah, it says 48%. So I still have half the battery according to that. Probably a little bit more than half the battery. But this will give you a general idea of what it can do. Full throttle for 20 miles without any loss of power at all. I've been going full throttle this whole time. We're almost at 28 miles. Still got almost 50% battery left. You tell me, is it worth the upgrade? I think so. I can literally go so many places. Especially if I go PAS1, which I might do a PAS1 test and drive all the way to another city that's pretty far away from here. Now, I'll have to, maybe wear like a reflective vest or something, I don't really know.
So we did a total trip time of 1 hour and 57 minutes. We started at 4:05 and ended at 6:02. We had a maximum speed of 39 miles per hour. With a total distance of 28.38 miles, we only used about 50% battery doing that many miles with this dual battery setup. The average speed while we were moving was 21 miles per hour with a total move time of 1 hour and 20 minutes. If you have any questions at all, please leave them down in the comments. There is a full install video that I just recently posted about how to do this setup with the Ariel Rider Kepler. You can also do the same setup with the other e-bikes, so check that out. If you read my blog, it has full written instructions on how to do the setup. And if you have any questions again, leave them down in the comments, and I'll see you guys in the next video.